Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss with you The Death of the Author, a critical essay by Roland Barthes. Roland Barthes is a French literary theorist and philosopher. Writing with Zero, The Elements of Semiology, Sasa, these are the seminal works of Roland Barthes. Under the influence of Jacques Lacan and Jacques Derrida, he concentrated on exploring the emergence of meaning in the process of reading. Now come to the essay. Roland Barthes begins it with the story Sarrasine by Honoré de Balzac, who is a French writer. Roland Barthes mentioned a sentence from the story as, "It was woman, with her sudden fears, her irrational whims, her instinctive fears, her unprovoked bravado, her daring and her delicious delicacy of feeling." Then Roland Barthes interrogates who is speaking in this story and whose voice it is. Is it the story's hero? Is it the man Balzac? Is it the author Balzac? Is it universal wisdom or romantic psychology? Roland Barthes says, we shall never know whose voice it is in the story, because writing is the destruction of every voice and the destruction of every point of origin. Moreover, Roland Barthes stresses that writing is neutral, composite, oblique space, where our subject, I mean, what we write, slips away and where all identity is lost. When the author enters into his own death, writing begins. In ancient society, the narration of texts were never done by a person, as you call the author. Instead, a mediator, showman, or speaker involved in narration, whose mastery of the narrative code may be admired, but never his individual genius admired. During the end of the Middle Ages, the society views author as a modern figure, and with the English empiricism, French rationalism, and individual faith of Reformation, the society granted the special responsibility to the individual, that is the author. The author is at the center, with all his personal life, experiences, and so on. Even criticism considers nothing more than an explanation of author's ideas, his life, and habits. The voice of a single person, the author confiding in us, if the work lives through the author. In other words, if we follow the voice of the author, he will make us to believe what he has written in his text. The image of the author over his work began to weaken in French literature. Both the French symbolist poets Stephen Mallarmé and Paul Valéry gave us a new way of separating the language from the author who is supposed to be the owner of the language. Mallarmé views that it is the language which speaks to us and not the author. He says, writing is an act of impersonality. The separation of language allows freedom to act and perform without any controlling authority. As Mallarmé said, linguistically, the author is never anything more than the man who writes, just as I is no more than the man who says I. Language knows a subject, not a person. And Roland Barthes claims that a text is not a line of words releasing a single theological meaning, that is the meaning of the author God. A text has multi-dimensional space in which a variety of writings, none of them original, blend and clash. This is what Roland Barthes says, the text is a tissue of quotations drawn from the innumerable centers of culture. By eliminating the other, we grant text on individuality and freedom. By acknowledging the presence of the other, traditional criticism found its job easy, and it limited to explaining the reality of the other. At last, coming back to the sentence of the story, Sarrasine, it was woman with her sudden fears, her irrational whims, her instinctive fears, her unbroken bravado, her daring and her delicious delicacy of feeling. Here, Roland Barthes says, no person says it in the story. Its source, its voice, is not the true place of the writing, which is all come from the reading. A text is made of multiple writings drawn from many cultures, and this multiplicity is focused on the reader, not the author. The reader has more active role than the writer, who does not exist. Finally, Roland Barthes closes his essay by saying, To give future to the field of writing, one should destroy the myth, that is, the birth of the reader must be at the cost of the death of the author. In other words, once a writer publishes his work, it is no longer for his interpretation, but of the reader to create meaning. In this way, the birth of the reader spells the death of the author. And finally, thanks for watching this video. Subscribe this channel for more videos. Thank you.